أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لقد أرسلنا رسلنا بالبينات وأنزلنا معهم الكتاب والميزان ليقوم الناس بالقسط. صدق الله العظيم.
نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم، أما بعد. As you know, we shall be starting today with the last section of Surah Al-Kahf. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. أفحسب الذين كفروا أن يتخذوا عبادي من دوني أولياء إنا أعتدنا جهنم للكافرين نزلا. قل هل ننبئكم بالأخسرين أعمالا. الذين ضل سعيهم في الحياة الدنيا وهم يحسبون أنهم يحسنون صنعا. صدق الله العظيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. اللهم ربنا ألهمنا رشدنا وأعذنا من شرور أنفسنا. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه، وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. آمین یا رب العالمین. اٹس اے کامن پرنسپل ان دی قرآن دیٹ ان دی ویریس سوراز دی آیات وچ اپیئر ان دی بگننگ اینڈ دی آیات وتھ وچ دی سورا اینڈس دے آر موسٹ پروفاؤنڈ، موسٹ پروفاؤنڈ. سیم از دی کیس دی سورۃ الکہف آلسو. And that is why we find traditions and sayings of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Whosoever will keep reading and reciting the ayat in the beginning of Surah Al-Kahf and the ayat with which the surah ends, he will be saved from the fitna of Dajjal. So these ayat have a special effect. And because, you know, in the beginning also we found the central ayat was inna ja'alna ma'al al-ardi zinatan laha linabluwahum ayyuhum ahsanu 'amala. And I noted it last night that twice again this word zinat appears. wala ta'du 'aynaka 'anhum turidu zinatal hayatid dunya al-mal wal banun zinatul hayatid dunya. So the central idea is that this world is very beautiful, and as man is advancing in technology, the beauty of this world is becoming more and more. It's more and more attractive, more and more awful. So now man is loving this world more and more. And this is the only test to which we have been put in this world, this life of this world. خَلَقَ الْمَوْتَ وَالْحَيَاةَ لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا. He has created life and death so as to test you. Who amongst you is the doer of the good deeds? And this is the crucial matter, whether you love this world or you love Allah and the hereafter. If we fail in this, if we are fully devoted to this world, then we fail in the akhirah. And if we have fixed our priority number one is that world and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is only a journey. We are passing by it. As the Prophet said, "Kun fi dunya kaannaka ghareebun wa aabiru sabeel." You should live in this world as if you are some stranger or a traveler. That's all. This is not your house. This is not your home. Your home is actually Akhirah. Now in the end also you find, first of all, the denunciation of the shirk. Mostly the shirk in this world has been that people have adopted as gods and goddesses, according to their own imagination, the daughters or sons of Allah. Some of the Jews said, Uzair is son of Allah. So we must worship him. And you know, Christianity is based on this principle, the only begotten Son of God. And he is the God real. That Asmani God, you know, the God in heaven, the Father, Heavenly Father, he is not very important. Really important is Jesus. He is the real God. In the same way, the Mushrikeen of Arab, they had the idea that these angels are daughters of Allah. And that is why they had their deities with the feminine names. Manat, Lat, Uzza, these are feminine names. So, here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, أَفَحَسِبَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا وَيَتَّخِذُوا عِبَادِي مِن دُونِي أَوْلِيَا. And why do these mushrikeen worship these small gods and goddesses? They think that they will intercede on their behalf on the Day of Judgment. They will be able to save those people who love them from the accountability of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is their wrong idea. Allah says, أَفَحَسِبَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا. So then those who have disbelieved, they think, أَنْ يَتَّخِذُوا عِبَادِي مِن دُونِي أَوْلِيَا, that they can make my servants, my bondsmen, as their protectors against me. Jesus, I created him, I sent him as a messenger. Now will he protect these people against me? Against my questioning? Malaika, they are my creation. They are my bondsmen. Will they intercede on their behalf against me? أَفَحَسِبَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا وَيَتَّخِذُوا عِبَادِي مِن دُونِي أَوْلِيَا إِنَّا أَعْتَدْنَا جَهَنَّمَ لِلْكَافِرِينَ نُزُلًا. For such disbelievers and rejectors of the faith, we have already prepared hell for their entertainment and hospitality. Now the crux of the matter of Surah Al-Kahf. قُلْ هَلْ نُنَبِّئُكُمْ بِالْأَخْسَرِينَ أَعْمَالًا. Say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, should we inform you who are the greatest losers regarding their deeds and endeavors in this world? Everybody is working hard from dawn to sunset, rather late night. People are working, 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 running. Running to this direction, running to that direction. But what is the goal? What is the aim? Now, if all this running and all this endeavor and all this striving is for this world, it means they are lost. They are gum, according to the saying of Iqbal. Kafir ki ye pehchan ke afaq mein gum hai. They have been lost in this world. أَفَحَسِبَ الَّذِينَ قُلْ هَلْ نُنَبِّئُكُمْ بِالْأَخْسَرِينَ أَعْمَالًا. Say to them, shall we inform them, who are the greatest losers in their striving in this world? And after this question, the answer Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving himself. أَلَّذِينَ ضَلَّ سَعْيُهُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. Those whose endeavor is wasted for this world only. All their time, all their working, all their exertions, day and night for this world. As if they are lost. Their striving, their endeavors, they are lost. الَّذِينَ ضَلَّ سَعْيُهُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَهُمْ يَحْسَبُونَ أَنَّهُمْ يُحْسِنُونَ الصُّنْعَ. And they think that they are going very good performance. Well, my business is flourishing, but I have put in labor in it, hard work, and the result I am having. My business is flourishing, I am shining in my career, in my profession. So they are contented that what they are endeavoring, they are getting the results. But the reality is, أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا بِآيَاتِ رَبِّهِمْ. They are the people who have disbelieved the revelations of their Lord. Allah says that is the real life, not this. This is only a temporary abode. You have to leave it. If not today, tomorrow. If not tomorrow, day after. That's all. Nobody says that he can live in this world forever. He has to leave. So, أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا بِآيَاتِ رَبِّهِمْ. They may be saying that we believe in Quran. But if all their efforts are focused and lost for this world, that actually they don't believe in Quran. Quran says the real life is that, not this one. So you are belying Quran by your action, by your attitude. أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا بِآيَاتِ رَبِّهِمْ وَلِقَائِهِ. And they have denied that they will have to meet him, meet their Lord. فَحَبِتَ أَعْمَالُهُمْ. For all their good deeds, what they might have done, they have all gone in vain. فَلَا نُقِيمُ لَهُمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ وَزْنًا. And we are not going to assign any weight to them on the day of resurrection, on the day of judgment. Such people also do some good deeds to satisfy their conscience. Well, I am all very busy in this world affair, but I am earning, but I am giving some charity also. I am doing that business also. That, you know, public service work also I am doing. No, these things. Unless your goal is akhirah, unless you devote yourself for the most of your personality and your time and your energies and your means for akhirah, for the pleasure of Allah, you are doomed. ذَلِكَ جَزَاهُمْ جَهَنَّمْ. They are the people whose reward is going to be the hell. بِمَا كَفَرُوا. Due to the rejection of the faith. وَاتَّخَذُوا آيَاتِي وَرُسُلِي هُزُوَا. And they took my revelations and my messengers in mockery. What is he saying? That is the real life. Or real life is this. بَابَرْ بَعَشْكُوشْ كَيْ عَلَمْ دُبَارَ نِيسْتْ. This is the life. Enjoy as much as you can. Because there is not going to be another life. Babar Mahesh Kosh. Try to have as luxuries as you can have. Alam Dubara Nis, this life will not come to you again. So avail the best of it. That is actually, Babar had said so. We are doing according to that. Our whole life pattern is absolutely on that basis. Now the contrast. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. On the contrary, those people who believe and do good deeds, كَانَتْ لَهُمْ جَنَّاتُ الْفِرْدَوْسِ نُزُلُوا. For them, the gardens, they have been prepared, gardens of paradise, shall be ready for their hospitality. خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا. Abiding therein forever. لَا يَمْغُونَ عَنْهَا هِوَانَا. They will never like to be transferred from there to any other place. قُلْ لَوْ كَانَ الْبَحْرُ مِدَادًا لِكَلِمَاتِ رَبِّي. Please note, the last two ayat of Surah Bani Israel were started with قُلْ. قُلْ إِنُّ اللَّهَ عَبِدُ الرَّحْمَانَ أَيَّمَّا تَدُوْ فَلَهُ الْأَسْمَاءُ الْحُسْنَى. قُلْ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ الَّذِي لَمْ يَتَّخِذْ وَلَدًا وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ شَرِيكٌ فِي الْمُلْكِ وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ وَلِيٌّ مِنَ الظُّلْمِ وَكَبِّرْهُ تَكْبِيرًا. The grandeur of the person of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his high station, his uniqueness, his unity. Two ayat, the last two ayat of Surah Bani Israel, very, very profound. In the same way, the last two ayat of Surah Al-Kahf, they also start with Qul. There are two Quls in the end of Surah Bani Israel and two Quls in the end of Surah Al-Kahf. We are very well aware and familiar with four quls. قُلْ يَا أَيُّهَا الْكَافِرُونَ. قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٌ. قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ. قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ. But these are four another quls that you must remember. They are remember worthy. Now the grandeur of Allah's creation. قُلْ لَوْ كَانَ الْبَحْرُ مِدَادًا لِكَلِمَاتِ رَبِّي. Say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if the whole sea was to be used as an ink to write the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my Lord, the sea will be exhausted before the words of Allah are exhausted. Although another sea of the like might be brought for its help. Now what does it mean? Every creation of Allah is his word, kun. Everything is created by one word, kun. So every creation is a word of Allah. Can you count down and write down all the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Even if the oceans are to be used as ink, and there's another ayah in the Quran of this on the same subject, if all the trees on the earth are to be turned into pens, kalimatullah will not be able to be exhausted and written. So this is to give you an impression of the grandeur of the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And now comes the last ayah, and this is the practical tawheed. One tawheed is theoretical. Allah is alone. Nobody is equal to Him. None is a partner with Him. There is no associate with Him. There is no associate in His attributes, etc., etc. All these things are theoretical. What's practical tawheed is, you worship Him and Him and Him alone. Obey Him and Him and Him alone. You can obey others only where there is no disobedience to Allah. Your obedience, your worship should be 100% focused on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the practical tawheed. I have a book on this subject, Tawheed-e-Amali in Urdu. And this aspect of tawheed is absolutely absent. Even those of our people, you know, who think that they are the muwahideen and they are the salafiyun and so on and so forth, they don't care about this amali tawheed. Now here is the amali tawheed. Last ayah of Surah Bani Israel, theoretical tawheed. قُلْ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ الَّذِي لَمْ يَتَّخِذْ وَلَدًا وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ شَرِيكٌ فِي الْمُلْكِ وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ وَلِيٌّ مِنَ الذُّلِّ وَكَبِّرْهُ تَكْبِيرًا. And here, قُلْ, say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, إِنَّمَا أَنَا بَشَرٌ مِثْلُكُمْ. Verily, I am also a mortal human like you. The only difference between you and me is yuha ilayya. Wahi has come to me. Revelations have come to me. And what is the crux of the revelation? Annama ilahukum ilahu wahid. That your Lord is the only one Allah. One Lord, one God. No partner with Him. فَمَنْ كَعْلَ يَرْجُوا لِقَاءَ رَبِّهِ. So whosoever is hopeful and looking forward to meet his Lord, فَلْيَعْمَلْ صَالِحًا عَمَلًا صَالِحًا. Now he has to do two things. He must do good deeds. Number one, وَلَا يُشْرِكْ بِعِبَادَةِ رَبِّهِ أَحَدًا. And he shouldn't associate in his obedience to Allah. Ibadah means obedience. Abd is slave. In obedience and worship of Allah, he should not associate anything else, anybody else. So this is the end of Surah Al-Kahf. And now we come to Surah Maryam. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Kaf ha ya ayn sad. This surah begins with five letters. The surahs begin with one letter, Noon, Kaf, Sad. Then two, Hamim, Hamim. Then three, Alif Lam Mim, Alif Lam Ra. We have gone through them. Then two with four, Alif Lam Mim Ra, Alif Lam Mim Saad. And two surahs of the Quran begin with five letters. One is this, Kaf, Ha, Ya, Ain, Saad. The other is Surah Ash-Shura, Ha, Mim, Ain, Sin, Kaf. Zikru Rahmati Rabbik Abdahu Zakariya. This is the narration of your Lord's mercy, which was bestowed upon His bondsman, His servant Zakariya. Is nada rabbahu nidaan khafiyya. Just recall, when he called upon his Lord secretly, in a very low voice, qala rabbi inni wahana al-azmu minni. He said, oh my Lord, my bones have become weak. Washta'ala rasu shayban. And my head is now covered with grey and white hair. وَلَمْ أَكُمْ بِدُعَائِكَ رَبِّ شَقِيَّةِ. And throughout my life, I have never been unblessed after calling upon you, after praying you. You always granted my prayers. So I am taking the courage to ask you for something, something big. Because you have been granting my prayers all the life. So that has given me the courage. What is that request? وَإِنِّي خِفْتُ الْمَوَالِيَ مِنْ وَرَائِي. And I fear that after me, my relatives will not take the right attitude. وَكَانَتْ إِمْرَاتِ عَاقِرًا. And my wife has been barren all the life. فَهَبْ لِي مِنْ لَدُنْكَ وَلِيًّا. So please grant me from your special bounty a heir, someone who can continue my mission. Yare suni, who should inherit me. وَيَرِثُ مِنْ آلِ يَعْقُوبِ. And all the spiritual heritage of the house of Yaqub, he should inherit. وَجَعَلْهُ رَبِّ رَضِيًّا. And, O Lord, make him acceptable to thee, and pleasing to you, and pleased with you. Razi goes both ways. You are pleased with somebody, this is also Razi. Somebody is pleased with you, this is also Razi. Fa'il. Ya Zakariya, Nadi, this prayer was answered by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. O Zakariya, inna nubashshiruka bi ghulamin. We give you the glad tidings of a son. Ismuhu Yahya. His name would be Yahya. Lam naj'al lahu min qablu samiyya. We have not made for him aforetime a namesake. This name has never been allotted to any human being before him. He will be the first person to be given the name of Yahya. قَالَ رَبِّ أَنَّا يَكُونَ لِي غُلَامٌ. Although he prayed himself, but you know, he doesn't appear to believe that in this old age of mine, he was very old, grown very old. And now all the life, his wife Hanna had been barren. No issue. So how can now she have a son? قَالَ رَبِّ أَنَّا يَكُونُ لِي غُلَامٌ وَكَانَتِ امْرَأَتِي عَاقِرًا. He said, oh my Lord, how can I have a son while my wife has been barren all the life? وَقَدْ بَلَغْتُ مِنَ الْكِبْرِ عِتِيًّا. And I myself have reached the extreme old age. قَالَ كَذَلِكَ. The reply came, it will happen in this very way. Despite of your old age and barrenness of your wife, you will be given a son. قَالَ رَبُّكَ هُوَ عَلَيَّ حَيِّنٌ. Your Lord says, this is very easy for me. I am not bound by these laws of nature. I have framed these laws of nature. They need my permission. I am not bound by these laws. هُوَ عَلَيَّ حَيِّنٌ. It's very easy for me. وَقَدْ خَلَقْتُكَ مِنْ قَبْلُ وَلَمْ تَكُ شَيْئًا. Just recall, I created you while you were nothing. What were you? A drop of sperm. And I created you out of it. So can't I, you know, give you a son? قَالَ رَبِّ جَلِّي آيَا. Hazrat Zakariya said, okay, O Lord, now fix for me some sign that I should know that actually this will happen. قَالَ آيَتُكَ أَلَّا تُكَلِّمَ النَّاسَ ثَلَاثَ لَيَالٍ سَوِيًّا. He said, Allah said, replied, the sign for you is that you will not be able to talk to the people for 3 nights. You will become dumb. Saviya, although you will not be sick or old, you will be sound and healthy. But this faculty of speaking will be taken away from you. This is the sign. فَخَرَجَ عَلَىٰ قَوْمْهِ مِنْ الْمِحْرَابِ. He came out from his sanctuary where he was. He used to pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To his nation. فَأَوْحَا إِلَيْهِمْ. Now wahi, because he can't speak. So he conveyed to them by gestures. أَنْصَبِّحُوا بُكْرَةً وَعَشِيًّا. Glorify your Lord mornings and evenings. Now, so to say, scene one of the drama is finished. Now the number two. Now Yahya has been born. And now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is addressing Yahya. Ya Yahya, khudil kitab bi quwwah. O Yahya, son of Zakariya, hold fast to our book. Bi quwwah, with power and strength. Wa atainahu al-hukma sabiyya. And we granted him wisdom while he was still a child. These are exceptions. Masih alayhi salatu wassalam and Yahya, both are exceptions. They were given the wisdom from the very beginning of the life. وَحَنَانًا مِنْ لَدُنَّهُ. And he had all the tenderness in his heart, which we gave him, وَزَكَاتًا and purity, وَكَانَ تَقِيًّا. And he was God-fearing. وَبَرَّمْ بِوَالِدَيْهِ. And he was very dutiful to his parents. وَلَمْ يَكُنْ جَبَّارًا عَصِيًّا. And he was not arrogant or rebellious against the parents. وَسَلَامٌ عَلَيْهِ يَوْمَ وَلِدَ. And peace be upon him on the day on which he was born, وَيَوْمَ يَمُوتُ, and on the day when he will die, وَيَوْمَ يُبْعَثُ حَيَّا, on the day when he will be resurrected. Now this first section gives us the story of Yahya, Zakariya, wife of Zakariya, or mother of Yahya, Hannah. The birth of Yahya was not according to the usual rules. Father having reached the extreme old age, mother having been all the life barren. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them a son. Now this is actually a preface to the description of the birth of Jesus alayhi salatu wassalam. Mazkur fil kitab Maryam, mentioned in this book, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi sallam, Maryam, salamu alayha, is in tabazat min ahliha makanan sharqiyya. When she withdrew from her people to an eastern place, فَقَخَذَتْ مِن دُونِهِمْ حِجَابًا, and he put a screen from the others to be isolated. فَأَرْسَلْنَا إِلَيْهَا رُوحَنَا, we sent to her our angel, our ruh. I told you, angel is also ruh, our arwa also ruh, and wahi also ruh. These three things which belong to the world of Amr, Alamul Amr, they are all ruh. Ruhana, we sent our angel, that is Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam, Ar-Ruhul Qudus, Ar-Ruhul Ameen. فَتَبَسَّلَ لَهَا بَشَرًا سَوِيًّا, he appeared before Mary, Maryam salamun alayha, as a full and sound man. قَالَتْ إِنِّي عُوذُ بِالرَّحْمَانِ مِنْكَ إِن كُنْتَ تَقِيًّا, Maryam said, I take refuge in Rahman, the compassionate, in Allah, from you, if you are a righteous person. قَالَ إِنَّمَا أَنَا رَسُولُ رَبِّكَ, he said, don't fear, I am no man, I am an angel. I have been sent by your Lord, a messenger from your Lord. لِأَهَبَ لَكِ غُلَامًا ذَكِيًّا, so that I may bestow on you a righteous son. قَالَتْ أَنَّا يَكُونُ لِي غُلَامٌ, she also wondered, she said, how can I bear a son? وَلَمْ يَمْسَسْنِي بَشَرٌ, no male has ever touched me. وَلَمْ أَكُ بَغِيًّا, and I have not been a wicked woman, unchaste woman. قَالَ كَذَلِكَ, the same answer. It will happen in this very way. قَالَ رَبُّكَ هُوَ عَلَيَّ حَيٌّ, your Lord says, it's easy for me. وَلَنَجْعَلَهُ آيَةً لِلنَّاسِ, and this is actually our decision, because we want to make him, Jesus, your son, a sign for the mankind. وَرَحْمَةً مِنَّا, and a mercy from us. وَكَانَ أَمْرًا مَقْضِيًّا, and this matter has already been decreed and decided. There can be now no two opinions. This is to happen. فَحَمَلَتْهُ, so she conceived him. فَانْتَبَذَتْ بِهِ مَكَانًا قَصِيًّا, and she withdrew with him to a very remote place. فَعَجَاهَا الْمَخَاضُ إِلَىٰ جِذِ النَّخْلَةِ, now when the birth pains and birth pangs came, she came to the trunk of a palm tree. قَالَتْ, now in this condition, just imagine, قَالَتْ يَا لَيْتَنِي مِتُّ قَبْلَ هَذَا وَكُنْتُ نَسْيًا مَنْسِيًّا, and she said, would that I had died before this and become a thing forgotten in oblivion. Now she was thinking, if I am going to give birth to a son, what will people say? What would be my explanation? Where from this son has come? So she is so much grieved. Ya laytani mittu qabla haza wa kuntu nasiyam mansiya. Would that I had died before this time and become a thing forgotten and oblivion. Fanada min tahtiha, then called the one who was beneath her. Allah tahzani, don't be grieved. Qad jala rabbuka tahta kisriya, your Lord has produced a water stream underneath you. Now who was the caller? Mostly people think he was the same angel Jibreel. But there I was very glad to find in one translation, because I thought that I'm the only one that holds that idea. But I have another, you know, support for that idea of mine, and that it was the baby Jesus himself. He talked to Maryam, salamun alayha, don't worry, And this miracle, when Maryam saw this miracle, my son is speaking. Then she had the, she could take the heart that yes, now I can go and face my people. He will testify when he is speaking to me while he is an infant. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will help me through this baby. فَنَادَاهَا. It was Hazrat Masih himself who called to her mother, لَا تَحْزَنِي. Don't be grieved. قَدْ جَالَ رَبُّكِ تَحْتَكِ سَرِيَّا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made a stream flow underneath you. وَحُزِّي إِلَيْكِ بِجِزِّ النَّخْلَةِ. And you just shake towards you the trunk of the palm tree. تُسَاقِتْ عَلَيْكِ رُطَبًا جَنِيَّا. The palm tree dates will drop on you fresh and ripe. فَكُلِي وَشُرَبِي. Then you eat and drink. وَقَرِّي عَيْنَا. And keep your eyes cool. By what? By seeing the sun. It happens. You know, mother, after worst pains and all that which comes to her during the birth of the child, but after the birth has taken place and child is given to her, all pain gone. Now she's smiling and she's kissing the child. So this is actually, you can cool your eyes by seeing me. And now if you happen to see somebody, some man, فَقُولِي, say to him, إِنِّي نَذَرْتُ لِلْرَّحْمَانِ صَوْمًا. I have woved a fast for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, فَلَنْ أُكَلِّمَ الْيَوْمَ إِنْسِيًّا. So I'm not going to talk to anybody. This was also a form of fasting in the Bani Israel, in the Jews, in which not only eating and drinking was prohibited, even speaking was also prohibited. فَعَتَتْ بِهِ قَوْمَهَا تَحْمِلُهُ. Now she came to her people, her nation, carrying him. قَالُوا يَا مَرْيَمُ لَقَدْ جَيْتِ شَيْئًا فَرِيًّا. People saw her bringing a child in her lap. O Maryam, you have certainly brought a thing most highness and most hate-worthy. يَا أُخْتَ هَارُون. O sister of Harun, مَا كَانَ أَبُوكِ امْرَأَ سَوْءٍ. Neither your father was a wicked person. وَمَا كَانَتْ أُمُّكِ بَغِيَّةٍ. Nor your mother was an unchaste and wicked woman. فَأَشَارَتْ إِلَيْهِ. She pointed towards the baby, Isa alayhi salam. قَالُوا كَيْفَ نُكَلِّمُ مَنْ كَانَ فِي الْمَهْدِ سَبِيَّةٍ. He said, how can we talk to this? Who is an infant? Who is in the cradle? An infant. How can he explain who he is and how he has come into being, into existence? فَأَشَارَتْ إِلَيْهِ. قَالُوا كَيْفَ نُكَلِّمُ مَنْ كَانَ فِي الْمَهْدِ السَّبِيَّةِ. How can we talk to him? قَالَ إِنِّي عَبْدُ اللَّهِ. Now Hazrat Masih said, I am the servant of Allah. آتَانِيَ الْكِتَابِ. He has given me a book, gospel. وَجَعَلَنِي نَبِيًّا. And he has made me a prophet. وَجَعَلَنِي مُبَارَكًا أَيْنَمَا كُنْتُ. And he has made me blessed wherever I am. وَأَوْصَانِي بِالصَّلَاةِ وَالزَّكَاةِ مَا دُمْتُ حَيًّا. And he has enjoined upon me the prayers and the zakah so long as I live. فَبَدْرًا بِوَالِدَتِي. And I am dutiful to my mother. Respectful, dutiful to my mother. وَلَمْ يَجْعَلْنِي جَبَّارًا شَقِيًّا. And he has not made me arrogant and unblessed. وَالسَّلَامُ عَلَيَّ يَوْمَ وُلِدْتُ. Peace be upon me the day I was born. وَيَوْمَ أَمُوتُ. And peace be upon me the day I will die. وَيَوْمَ أُبْعَثُ حَيًّا. And peace be upon me when I will be resurrected again. ذَلِكَ عِيسَى ابْنُ مَرْيَمَ. This was Jesus, son of Mary. These ayat were revealed to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the 5th year after the beginning of Wahi. And you have in history that when some of the Muslims, they migrated to Abyssinia, and then a deputation of Quraysh was sent to Najashi, Lagos, that you send these people, they have run away, they are our slaves who have run away, send them back. And then you know, they were called there in the court of Lagos, Najashi. And there, in the beginning he was ready, okay, your people, you can take them. But then Hazrat Jafar Tayyar radiallahu anhu, elder brother of Hazrat Ali radiallahu anhu, then he recited these ayat in the court of Najashi. And then Najashi said, what has been said about Isa here, Isa is not more than it, even an inch, or you may call anything, or rather or less in size. It is the exact description of Isa. So he confirmed. And then I said, okay, these people, if they believe in these things, I'm not going to send them back to you to, so that you can persecute them. Zalika Isa ibn Maryam. He was Isa, son of Maryam. قال الحق الذي فيه يمترون. And this is the word of truth about which they are doubting. ما كان لله أن يتخذ من ولد سبحانه. It doesn't behove to Allah. It's not behoving to Allah that He should take a son to Him. سبحانه. Glory be to Him. إذا قضى أمرا فإنما يقول له كن فيكون. When He decides about some matter, only He has to say, utter the word kun, and it becomes. وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ رَبِّي وَرَبُّكُمْ. Again, the saying of Jesus. Allah is my Lord and your Lord. فَعْبُدُوهُ هَذَا فَعْبُدُوهُ. Worship Him and Him alone. هَذَا صِرَاطُ مُسْتَقِيمُ. This is the right and straight path. فَاخْتَلَفَ الْأَحْزَابُ مِنْ بَيْنِهِمْ. But different sects, they differed about Him. Even among the Christians. You said he is a sorcerer. They condemned him to be crucified. And you know, the Christian said he is son of God. And there were so many sects about Jesus, God incarnate. Some of them thought he is God himself, not Trinity. He is himself God, God incarnate. God has come down on this earth in his form. So different forms of ideas were adopted by different people. فَاخْتَلَفَ الْأَحْزَابُ مِنْ بَيْنِهِمْ. فَوَيْلٌ لِلَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا مِنْ مَشْهَدَ يَوْمٍ عَظِيمٍ. So, though there be woe on them who have rejected and committed kufr on that day when they will be gathering before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أَسْمَيْ بِهِمْ وَأَبْصِرُ. On that day, يَوْمَ يَعْتُونَنَا, when they will come to us, how good they will be listening and how good they will be seeing. لَكِنِ الظَّالِمُونَ الْيَوْمَ فِي ظَلَالٍ مُبِينٍ. But these evildoers today, they are in manifest error. وَأَنْزِرْهُمْ يَوْمَ الْحَسْرَةِ. And O Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, you warn them against that day of despair and anguish. إِذَا قُضِيَ الْأَمْرُ, when all the matters will be decided. وَهُمْ فِي غَفْلَةٍ وَهُمْ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. And they are paying no attention and they are not believing in what you are telling them. إِنَّا نَحْنُ نَرِسُ الْأَرْضَ وَمَنْ عَلَيْهَا. We are going to inherit the whole of the world and whatever is over it. وَإِلَيْنَا يُرْجَعُونَ. Now you own this and you own this and he owns this and this building belongs to him and so on and so forth. But the whole inheritance will remain for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You will all be gone. إِنَّا نَحْنُ نَرِسُ الْأَرْضَ وَمَنْ عَلَيْهَا. Whatever is on it, we shall be inheriting everything. فَإِلَيْنَا يُرْجَعُونَ. And to us they will be returned. Now we come to Raskur fil Kitab Ibrahim. Mentioned in this book, Ibrahim also, alayhi salatu wassalam. إِنَّهُ كَانَ صِدِّيقًا نَبِيًّا. He was a truthful person to the utmost, and a messenger, and a prophet. إِسْقَالَ لِأَبِيهِ. Recall when he said to his father, يَا أَبَتِ, O dear father, لِمَ تَعْبُدُ مَا لَا يَسْمَعُ وَلَا يُفْسِرُ وَلَا يُغْنِي عَنْكَ شَيْئًا. Why do you worship these idols which neither can see nor listen and they cannot benefit you in any way? يَا أَبَتِ, O my dear father, إِنِّي قَدْ جَاءَنِي مِنَ الْعِلْمِ. Verily, to me a knowledge has come, that is of wahi, which is not given to all the people. Allah has been sending wahi to only the prophets. So a knowledge has come to me. إِنِّي قَدْ جَاءَنِي مِنَ الْعِلْمِ مَا لَمْ يَأْتِكَ, which didn't come to you. You are father, I am son. You are older, I am younger. But still, this revelation has come to me. It didn't come to you. فَاتَّبِعْنِي. So you will have to follow me. أَهْدِكَ صِرَاطًا سَوِيًّا. I will guide you to the right path. Ya Abate. Now see how he is addressing. In most respectable way, most respectable, sincerity. Ya Abate, oh my dear father, La Ta'budi Shaitan, don't worship Satan. Inna Shaitana kan lil Rahmani Asiya. Verily, Satan has been, for the compassionate, he has been in rebellion against him. Ya Abate inni akhaf wa yamassak adabu min ar-Rahman. Oh my dear father, I fear that some chastisement from Rahman, the compassionate Allah, will come to you. فَتَكُونَ لِلشَّيْطَانِ وَلِيَّا And then you will become a friend of Satan. Now what was the reply of Ibrahim's father? قَالَ رَاغِبٌ أَنْتَ عَنْ آلِهَتِي يَا إِبْرَاهِيمُ He said, O Ibrahim, are you rejecting my gods? لَإِنْ لَمْ تَنْتَهِ If you don't desist from it, لَأَرْجُمَنَّكَ I will stone you to death. وَهْجُرْنِي مَلِيَّا And get away from my sight. For a long period, get away. قَالَ السَّلَامُ عَلَيْكُ Ibrahim said, peace be upon you. سَأَسْتَغْفِرُ لَكَ رَبِّي Soon I will ask my Lord forgiveness for you. إِنَّهُ كَانَ بِي حَفِيَّا He is very gracious to me, very kind to me. He will accept my prayer for you. وَأَعْتَذِلُكُمْ وَمَا تَعْدُعُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ And I am leaving you and those whom you are calling upon, whom you are worshipping, except Allah. وَعَدُوا رَبِّي I will call my Lord. عَسَىٰ أَلَّا أَكُونَ بِدُعَاءِ رَبِّي شَقِيًّا And I hope that by calling upon my Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I will not remain unblessed. My prayers will be granted. فَلَمَّا اَعْتَذَلَهُمْ Then he left them. وَهَبْنَا لَهُ إِسْحَاقَ وَيَعْقُوبُ فَلَمَّا اَعْتَذَلَهُمْ وَمَا يَعْبُدُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ When he left them and the gods whom they were worshipping, وَهَبْنَا لَهُ إِسْحَاقَ وَيَعْقُوبُ We bestowed on him Ishaq as son and Yaqub as grandson, son of Ishaq. وَكُلًّا جَعَلْنَا نَبِيًّا And each one of them we made Nabi. Ishaq was also a prophet. And Yaqub was also a prophet, alayhi salatu wassalam. وَوَهَبْنَا لَهُمْ مِنْ رَحْبَتِنَا And we bestowed on them, all of them, from our mercy. وَجَعَلْنَا لَهُمْ لِسَانَ صِدْقٍ عَلِيًّا And we assigned to them a true and high renown. وَذْكُرْ فِي الْكِتَابِ مُوسَى And mentioned in this book, Moses also, Musa also. إِنَّهُ كَانَ مُخْلَصًا Verily he was a chosen person, we had chosen him. وَكَانَ رَسُولًا نَبِيًّا He was a messenger and a prophet. وَنَادَيْنَاهُ مِنْ جَانِبِ تُورِ الْأَيْمَنِ And we had called to him from the right side of the Mount Tur. وَقَرَّبْنَاهُ نَجِيًّا And we had called him nearer and near so as to have a conversation with him. وَوَهَبْنَا لَهُ مِنْ رَحْمَتِنَا أَخَاهُ هَارُونَ نَبِيًّا And we bestowed on him out of our mercy his brother Harun. We give him also prophethood and made him also prophet because he had requested it. We shall read in the next surah, Surah Taha. وَذْكُرْ فِي الْكِتَابِ إِسْمَعِيلِ Also make mention in this book of Ismail, alayhi salatu wassalam, إِنَّهُ كَانَ صَادِقُ الْوَعْدِ He was true to his promises. وَكَانَ رَسُولَ النَّبِيَّ He was also a messenger and a prophet. وَكَانَ يَعْمُرُ أَهْلَهُ بِالصَّلَاةِ وَالزَّكَاةِ وَكَانَ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِ مَرْضِيَّ And he used to command his family for salah and zakah. And he was, according near his Lord, he was approved one. وَذْكُرْ فِي الْكِتَابِ إِدْرِيسِ Also mentioned in this book, Idris. The name of Idris in Bible is Inak. Akhnuk, Anuk, Anuk. وَذْكُرْ فِي الْكِتَابِ إِدْرِيس إِنَّهُ كَانَ صِدِّيقًا نَبِيًّا He was also a truthful person to the utmost and a prophet. وَرَفَعْنَاهُ مَكَانًا عَلِيًّا And we had raised him to a very high position. أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ These are the people whom we sent our blessings مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ From among the prophets. They are all prophets. مِنْ زُرِيَةِ آدَمْ From the progeny of Adam alayhi salatu wassalam. وَمِمَّنْ حَمَلْنَا مَعَلُوهُ and the progeny of those whom we carried on the boat, on the ark with Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam, wa min zurriyat Ibrahim wa Israel, and from among the progeny of Ibrahim and Israel, Israel means Yaqub, wa mimman hadayna, and from those whom we had guided, wajtabayna, and whom we had selected, iza tutla alayhim ayatul rahmani kharru sujjatan wa bukiyya. This was their practice, that when the ayat of the compassionate Allah was recited to them, they used to fell down on the ground and prostrating, weeping. This is ayah of prostration. So make a sajda, please. فَخَلَفَ مِنْ بَعْدِهِمْ خَلْفٌ أَضَعُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَاتَّبَعُوا الشَّهَوَاتِ فَسَوْفَ يَلْقَوْنَ غَيَّا. Then there succeeded after them a generation which was unworthy, who wasted salah and followed the lusts of this world, the desires of the id and libido. So they shall soon encounter the chastisement. Illa man taba, except those who repent, wa amana, and now again renew their faith, iman, wa amila salihan, and do good deeds, fa ulaika yadkhuluna al-jannah, they will enter paradise. وَلَا يُزْلَبُونَ الشَّيَا, and they will not be wronged. Every good deed of theirs will be rewarded in full. جَنَّاتِ عَبْدٍ الَّتِي وَعَدَ الرَّحْمَانُ عِبَادَهُ بِالْغَيْبِ, and what will be their reward? The gardens of perpetual bliss which the compassionate Allah, Rahman, He has promised for them. And this promise was given for His bondsmen in the unseen. إِنَّهُ كَانَ وَعَدُهُ مَعْتِيًّا, verily, His promise is ever to be fulfilled. He is not going to fall back on His promise. لَا يَسْمَعُونَ فِيهَا لَغْوًا إِلَّا سَلَامًا. Now after entering into paradise, they will not have to even listen to any vain talk except salam and salam and salam. All the malaika will be coming to them and saying salam. Salaman salama. This salam is repeated in Surah Al-Waqi'ah. وَلَهُمْ رِزْقُهُمْ فِيهَا بُكْرَةً وَعْشِيًّا, and they will have the provision and food for them, evenings and mornings. تِلْكَ الْجَنَّةُ الَّتِي نُورِسُ مِنْ عِبَادِنَا مَنْ كَانَ تَقِيًّا. This is the garden which we shall cause thereof our servants to inherit who are God-fearing. They will inherit, and we shall make them inherit this garden. وَمَا نَتَنَزَّلُ إِلَّا بِأَمْرِ رَبِّكَ, and we cannot come down and descend but with the command of your Lord. This is the saying of Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam wanted that this revelation should come to me with a higher speed. There was pause, and this pause, you know, that became at times unbearable for him. He wanted more and more of it should come. So he complained to Jibreel alayhi salam, you don't come for a number of days and we have to wait for you. You should come more frequently. This is the reply. وَمَا نَتَنَزَّلُ إِلَّا بِأَمْرِ رَبِّكَ, we can't descend except by the command of your Lord. لَهُ مَا بَيْنَ أَيْدِينَا وَمَا خَلْفَنَا, to him belongs whatever is in front of us and whatever is behind us. وَمَا بَيْنَ ذَلِكَ, and whatever is between the two. Now just imagine. To him belongs what is in front of me, and to him belongs which is behind me. And what is in between the two? Who is in between the two? I am in between the two. So what he says, Jibreel is saying, that we are absolutely, we have to submit to the command of your Lord. We have no will, no free will to do whatever we like. لَهُ مَا بَيْنَ أَيْدِينَا وَمَا خَلْفَنَا وَمَا بَيْنَ ذَلِكَ وَمَا كَانَ رَبُّكَ نَسِيًّا, and your Lord does never forget. Don't think that this pause, you know, is because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has forgotten to send the wahi. No, no. It is based on His wisdom and hikmah. رَبُّ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ, He is the Lord of the heavens and the earth. وَمَا بَيْنَهُمَا, and all of these things which are between them. فَعْبُدْهُ, so worship Him, وَاسْتَبِرْ لِعِبَادَتِهِ, and show perseverance in obedience to him. Hal ta'lamu lahu samiyya? Do you know any person like him, comparable to him, or equal to him? وَيَقُولُ الْإِنسَانُ وَإِذَا مَا مِتُّ لَسَوْفَ أُخْرَجُ حَيَّا. And man says in exclamation, oh, when I am died, I am dead, will I again be taken out from my grave as a living creature? أَوَلَا يَذْكُرُ الْإِنسَانُ أَنَّا خَلَقْنَاهُ مِنْ قَبْلُ. Does this man not recall that we have created him before? وَلَمْ يَكُ شَيْئًا. He was nothing. We created him out of a drop of sperm. That's all. If we could create him, can't we create him again? فَوَرَبِّكَ. So by your Lord, I swear by your Lord, لَنَحْشُرَنَّهُمْ وَالشَّيَاطِينَ. We shall definitely gather all these unbelievers and all the Satans. ثُمَّ لَنُحْضِرَنَّهُمْ حَوْلَ جَهَنَّمَ جَسِيَّا. And then we shall bring them around the hell, and they will be kneeling on the ground. ثُمَّ لَنَنْزِعَنَّ مِنْ كُلِّ شِيَةٍ أَيُّهُمْ أَشَدُّ عَلَى الرَّحْمَانِ عَتِيَّا. Then we shall certainly draw out from every sect and every community who was most rebellious against the compassionate Allah. ثُمَّ لَنَنْزِعَنَّ مِنْ كُلِّ شِيَةٍ أَيُّهُمْ أَشَدُّ عَلَى الرَّحْمَانِ عَتِيَّا. ثُمَّ لَنَحْنُ عَالَمُ بِالَّذِينَ هُمْ أَوْلَى بِهَا صِلِيَّا. And then we definitely know best who has the right of entering that hell first, before all, first of all. وَإِنْ مِنْكُمْ إِلَّا وَارِدُهَا. O mankind, there is none from amongst you who is not to come there. Even the believers will once be taken to Jahannam to show them this is the thing from which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has saved you. Every human being will be made to pass, you know, that as-sirat in the hashr, that is over hell. And Muslims have to pass. We shall read it in Surah Al-Hadid and then again in Surah Al-Tahreem. So that stage is to come on the Day of Judgment. So everybody will see the Jahannam. وَإِن مِّنكُمْ إِلَّا وَارِدُهَا كَانَ عَلَىٰ رَبِّكَ حَتْمًا مَقْضِيًّا. And this is a decreed and decided thing with your Lord. ثُمَّ نُنَجِّي الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. Then we shall save those who had the faith and iman. وَنَذَرُ الظَّالِمِينَ فِيهَا جِسِيًّا. As for the evildoers, we shall leave them there. They will be there, evildoers, kneeling down. وَإِذَا تُطْلَى عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُ بَيِّنَاتٍ. And when our clear ayat, revelations, are read to them, recited to them, قَالَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا. Those who disbelieve, they say, لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. To the believers, أَيُّ الْفَرِيقَيْنِ خَيْرٌ مَقَامًا وَأَحْسَنُ نَدِيًّا. Which of the two parties is better in station and goodlier in assembly? The kuffar of Quraysh used to say to Muslims, look to Abu Jahl. His courtyard is so wide. So many people are always there. Who is there with Muhammad? None. So who has the respect in this world? Abu Jahl has the respect. Abu Lahab has the respect. Muhammad has no respect. And we have riches. We have wealth. We have nothing. So who amongst us is more beloved to Allah? They were measuring the love of Allah for creatures by the wealth that Allah has given them. So ayyul fariqayn khairum maqamum wa ahsanun niyya. Wa kam ahlakna qablahum min qarnin. Allah says, how many a generation we had destroyed before them. Hum ahsanu asasam wa riyya. Their positions and their outward pomp and show was much more than the possessions and pomp and show of these Quraysh. قُلْ مَنْ كَانَ فِي الدَّلَالَةِ فَلْيَمْدُدْ لَهُ الرَّحْمَانُ مَدَّ. Say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who is, مَنْ كَانَ فِي الدَّلَالَةِ فَلْيَمْدُدْ, who is in error, who has gone to the wrong path. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will prolong his term and give him respite. حَتَّى إِذَا رَاوْ مَا يُعَدُونَ. Till that time that when they see with their eyes what is being promised to them, إِمَّا السَّاعَةَ وَإِمَّا الْعَذَابِ. either the chastisement coming to them or the hour, the doomsday comes to them. فَسَيَعْلَمُونَ مَنْ هُوَ شَرُّ مَكَانًا وَأَضْعَفُ جُنْدًا. Then they will know who is worse in his position and who is weak regarding his armies. Either Muhammad was weak or Abu Jahl was weak. This will be clear on the day of judgment and when the chastisement comes to them. وَيَزِيدُ الَّذِينَ اَهْتَدَوْا هُدًى. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increases in guidance those who take to guidance. وَالْبَاقِيَاتُ الصَّالِحَاتُ الْخَيْرُ عِنْدَ رَبِّكَ سَوَابًا وَخَيْرٌ مَرَدًّا. And the good deeds, righteous good deeds, they are ever abiding. And they are better to return to when you will be returning to the hereafter. These deeds will be there waiting for you. أَفَرَأَيْتَ الَّذِي كَفَرَ بِآيَاتِنَا. So have you seen that person who has disbelieved our revelation? وَقَالَ لَهُ تَيَنَّ مَعْلَمْ وَبَلَدَا. And he says, I will definitely be given wealth and sons. We see that in Surah Al-Kahf also. That person who had two gardens, he said, I don't think this garden can be destroyed. وَلَيْرُدِدْتُ إِلَىٰ رَبِّي لَأَجِدَنَّ خَيْرًا مِنْهَا مُنْقَلَبًا. And if I am returned to my Lord, I will get much better than what I have here. This is the common thing of these, you know, disbelievers who are wealthy, well-to-do, that when he has blessed us here, well, he will bless us there also. And because you are deprived here, so in the same way you will be deprived in the hereafter also. أَفَرَأَيْتَ الَّذِي كَفَرَ بِآيَاتِنَا وَقَالَ لَهُ تَيَنَّ مَعْلَمَ وَلَدَا. أَتَّلَعَ الْغَيْبِ. Has he looked into the unseen future? What will happen? أَمِ اتَّخَذَ عِنْدَ الرَّحْمَانِ أَحْدًا. Or he has had a pledge from Rahman, compassionate, that he will definitely give him much more wealth in the hereafter. Kalla, not at all. سَنَكْتُبُ مَا يَقُولُ. We shall write down and record what he is saying. وَنَمُدُّ لَهُ مِنَ الْعَذَابِ مَدَّا. And we shall then lengthen and increase for him the chastisement. وَيَرِسُهُ مَا يَقُولُ. And we shall inherit from him what he says. Whatever he has, he will die. Inheritance will come to us. وَيَاتِينَا فَرْدَا. And when he comes to us, he will be all alone. No sons, no daughters, no servants, no wealth, no worldly belongings. He will come to us alone. وَاتَّخَذُوا مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ آلِهَةً. And they have adopted, besides Allah, gods. لَيَكُونُوا لَهُمْ عِزَّةً. So that they can become a basis of strength for them, for their defense. They will be able to defend them against the questioning of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Kalla, not at all. سَيَكْفُرُونَ بِعِبَادَتِهِمْ. Though they will refute that they never worshipped us. وَيَكُونُونَ عَلَيْهِمْ عِزَّةً. They will become enemies to them. Well, they say that they were worshipping us. The angels will say, no, no, no. They will stand to prosecute them. أَلَمْ تَرَ أَنَّا أَرْسَلْنَا الشَّيَاطِينَ عَلَى الْكَافِرِينَ تُوَزُّهُمْ أَزَّا. Have you not seen that we sent the Satans against the disbelievers to incite them vehemently into sin? The Satans come and incite us. أَلَّذِي يُوَسْوِسُ فِي صُدُورِ النَّاسِ مِنَ الْجِنَّةِ وَالنَّاسِ. فَلَا تَعْجَلْ عَلَيْهِمْ. So, O Prophet, O Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, don't be in haste against them. Don't pray to Allah that their matter should be decided immediately. Let Allah decide Himself. Whatever time Allah is giving, whatever term He is fixing for them, let you do Him. فَلَا تَعْجَلْ عَلَيْهِمْ. إِنَّمَا نَعُدُّ لَهُمْ عَدَّا. We are numbering their days. يَوْمَ يَحْشُرُ الشَّيَاطِينَ يَوْمَ نَحْشُرُ الْمُتَّقِينَ إِلَى الرَّحْمَانِ وَفْدًا. Recall the day when we shall gather the God-fearing people to the compassionate, just as a delegation is received. They will come and they will be received there as a delegation. وَنَسُوقُ الْمُجْرِمِينَ إِلَى جَهَنَّمَ وِرْدًا. And we shall drive the guilty to the hell as a herd. لَا يَمْلِكُونَ الشَّفَاعَةَ إِلَّا مَنِ اتَّخَذَ عِنْدَ الرَّحْمَانِ عَهْدًا. They shall have no power of intercession save him who has made a covenant with the compassionate Allah, Rahman. A few ayat are left, but with this, these we shall read, inshallah, in the next hour. بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعني وإياكم بالآيات والذكر الحكيم.
الله أكبر
The Islamic Organization of North America, IONA, is an organization dedicated to reviving the Quran into the hearts of Muslims while bringing its message to non-Muslims. The obligations of a Muslim as ordained by the Quran and Sunnah can be understood as having four levels. 1. A Muslim is required to develop real faith and conviction, iman, in one's heart. 2. A Muslim is required to live a life of complete submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 3. A Muslim is required to propagate and disseminate the message of Islam to humanity as a whole. 4. A Muslim is required to try his utmost in establishing the just Islamic order. The first and foremost objective of establishing IONA is to assist the Muslims in North America to uphold and implement these obligations, first on themselves, their families, inform their friends, and then to invite the non-Muslims to Islam. The ultimate goal is to seek Allah's pleasure and salvation in the hereafter. For more information about IONA, please visit us at www.tanzeem.us. You may also email us at info@tanzeem.us. or call our toll-free number, 866-779-IONA. Join us. Together, we can make a difference.